find it in your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
I'm back, y'all. I apologize about that, y'all. Had internet problems.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun, come with the
eye. See, I know something in that right there. Game got a lot of glitches in it, yo. Like, animations on here be so phony, yo. See if we can get this W, man. I can't get no gameplay. Okay, we got it.
And now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup.
Got a lot of golden tickets.
Ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go at the controls. Let's play. Turn here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. From the shotgun, Lawrence. Throw left side is complete on the diving effort.
What the fuck?
This one all the way past the 30.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
You circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs.
The reaction on this shit just straight awful, bro.
They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And he's able to get this way down deep into enemy territory.
A quarterback.
Time for Jacksonville. They go play action with Lawrence. Now a diving catch made just
a quarterback. A fucking quarterback.
Touchdown.
I done seen it all, yeah.
There to make the grab.
What's up, bro?
And the Jaguars drive right down the field and score.
Losing my fucking sanity on this goddamn game.
Point splits the uprights, and it's now a 7-0 game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
No.
Taken from about the 12. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line.
Yo, I just got cooked by a fucking quarterback. Catching the fucking ball for a touchdown. A quarterback, bro. How the fuck does that happen? A quarterback.
They'll run for the first time with Saquon Barkley. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
Bruh.
2 yards, the loss, second and 12.
I know, right?
Cunningham. This one goes out wide for Barkley. So back-to-back plays, each get nothing. And that's going to lead to a third and 12. Now Cunningham.
What the f-
releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
One of the goals of the game,
they've got passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10.
Wow.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
This game is fucking rigged. Yeah.
The benefit of good field position led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive.
And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. The sack that time by Michael Strahan. Back quite a ways here, facing 2nd and 19. Another try after the first down sack. Lawrence.
What the fuck was that? That's that shit I'm talking about, yo.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. He's got his receiver. It's Andre Rison. He's at the 50. The 30. 10. 5. Touchdown, Jaguars. Andre Rison. 94 yards, and the Jaguars are off to a 13-0 first quarter lead.
It's not much as perfect in football, but that's about as close to it as you're going to get. Score, force a punt, score again.
And both drives were impressive. The opening drive was, that last one was. Now on the other side, though, what's your psyche? You're really behind the eight ball.
You got to make sure you just hold in there. Survive.
And this is going to be intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off.
Can you tell me how I don't get it, yo. Like how, yo.
Pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you get a chance to take it all the way back at 2 points.
I fucking hate this game, yo.
That's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside.
I hate it, yo.
Across the 25 to the 27.
Yo, this game be cheating, yo. That fucking cross pattern with that touchdown was bullshit, yo.
They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up.
Look at this shit. It's like
officially it's a 1 yard loss. That's gonna bring up 2nd and 11.
I bet.
Off play action, it's Cunningham. Sliding out of the pocket, and that is incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass.
Yo, what is the deal? What the fuck?
Can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Josh Allen able to get him down for a loss of 11, and it brings up 4th down. 13-0 is the score after one on EA Sports.
Which Madden is that?
Drive goes backwards, so he's 22. Running away. A big boot that time, 57 yards the official distance. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the side.
And he can't get.
Can I get a fumble, please?
Jack Youngblood. Give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. 2nd and 24. They shakes him off. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Now Lawrence down around his goal line.
Oh my God.
That's Pat Freiermuth. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. An incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short, and it's fourth down. They'll run for it. It's Taylor. Room here to run. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. A huge play there on fourth down. That's sort of a prime example, is it not, of selling out defensively on fourth and short?
It certainly is, because what you're doing defensively is saying you're going to stop them right there at the line of scrimmage or make a play on the other side of the line of scrimmage. Instead, they get just enough of a hole chopped, and you're thin on the second and third levels. Then you become a...
And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Nick Foles. Charles and I settled here in the booth. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it. To get this one started, and off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. Hill is going to take it out of the end zone, and that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one, costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. They fake the give. Newton out to his left. Got a man. It's Randy Moss complete. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. A big connection on that one. 30 yards. From the 50, Newton. He gets it complete to Harris. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. So, Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath. Maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back, and he's able to...
And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. Credit the great Michael Strahan with a sack. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Newton. Throw right side is held on by the tight end Gonzalez. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20.
Nice methodical opening drive here. They're already into field goal range. They're in a good spot. You know that people like to take a shot in this part of the field. But at the same time, as methodical as they've been, they might want to run the ball a little bit here, too.
And just on the outskirts of the red zone, they have options now. Either way, though, they've come out with a purpose. On first down, Newton. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Newton steps away. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Randy Moss. Thank you.
What I have noticed out of all the competitors I just went against, three different competitors use the same plays over and over and over. Oh my God, man. Can I please get a good game?
Ultimate team matchup as you get a peek at some of the big players in today's game, and you heard a big player in today's game as well. Let's get the party started.
Hey, yo, these players are trash, bro. And they swear they are good, yo. Like, I just seen three players use the same fucking plays over and over again, yo. Like, literally on my footage. Like, literally. And they swear to God they nice, yo. I just say fuck it and rage quit and won't give a fuck about the L.
No run back here on the opening kickoff as we'll start at the 25.
Like, give me a fucking game, yo. Instead of seeing a whole bunch of fucking niggas sit back, jerk off all day, playing the same fucking plays like every fucking second of the goddamn game. Play the fucking game, nigga. God damn.
The drive will start with an option going left. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line.
Shit is a fucking noise.
That first play and it's second down. Now DiNucci. He finds his man complete. That's Bush. The 40 before he's out of bounds.
That turned into a very orchestrated play right there. Going to work his way out of the backfield to the right. And after he looked it in, he found plenty of space to roam and picked up big yardage.
A first carry now for Reggie Bush. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Now here's a handoff out of the gun. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go. Short side, and this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. After the loss, they'll come up 2nd and 13. DiNucci steps away to his left. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Play action. It's DiNucci. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Lawrence Taylor. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8. Second down, it's Bush, and he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a 3rd down. Relatively small sample size, but that's his longest run of the first quarter. Bounced it out to the outside to make it successful.
And to get there, you actually need some help. It's not just your pure speed getting to the corner, making sure that the blocking is taken care of inside so the pursuit doesn't get you. And oftentimes, those wide receivers, tight ends that might be flexed out, they've got to control the edge and make sure no one from the outside can spill the play before he gets there.
picked off by the Pro Bowl safety Cam Chancellor. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. No doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy. He forced it there. You saw the end result.
On the ground, this is
I do like his play calls. He's not a one-sided asshole.
Scoreless after one.
You feel me? I can actually enjoy the fucking game. The fuck?
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. A give to Barkley out of the gun. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up eight. They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go three and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college, I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him, if you don't take care of this football, you have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it, pick up first downs.
First down carry for Barkley. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Out of the shotgun, they run with Barkley. Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the
one-yard pickup.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Come on, niggas! The fuck?
By the defense here, they did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. Cunningham being chased, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. A big time.
Can you tell me how the fuck? Do he have two Charles Jones on both sides of the fucking field?
A good starting spot for the Saints as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 49. The drive starts with Reggie Bush. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to get the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do. For a tight end, he's got good straight line speed, and on that route, he's often the guy that gets overlooked. Nice job there finding him in stride for really good yardage.
Here's DiNucci to throw. And his throw is incomplete. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
To throw is DiNucci. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another.
You're fucking up, bro. You're doing the same shit again.
They've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync. Only way to play good defense.
He finds his man complete. That's Bush. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. So a big penalty there on the face mask leads to first and 10. Throwing is DiNucci. Flush to his right. Oh, it gets loose right side. And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll look to throw. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Lawrence Taylor gets him for a loss of 10 yards from his linebacker spot. It's second and goal, but now all the way back at the 14. They'll drop to throw. Forced hit as he throws, and the ball is out. It's a live football. It's going the other way. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 10. And he's going to bring the fumble back for a touchdown. And give some kudos to the defensive coordinator, I think, here. They bring the blitz, they dial it up, and it turns into 6 points for them.
It's so nice to hear you actually give kudos to the defense. It is so nice for such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. Out of the end zone comes Johnson. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And they've got just over 50 seconds to go till halftime, so they can try to put something
looking.
It's intercepted. Picked off at the 25, and he'll bring it back to the 9-yard line. An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging their defense now to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
They'll set up the screen to Barkley. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Second and goal from inside the five.
Come on, yeah.
Here's Cunningham. Dancing to his left. Is just a yard, and now it's third down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. And Barkley will try to punch it in. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. A 3-yard loss. Fourth down now. Now Morton Anderson for the field goal try. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Anderson's kick is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
You on this bullshit.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Looking deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has to be.
He's going to try that shit again.
He'll look to throw. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. They'll throw now on the final play. And as he throws, he lost the football. It's loose. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. 10-0 is our score as we get started again on EA Sports. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Second half begins with a run from Barkley. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
They'll run on first.
This motherfucker would not let me run.
A familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Cunningham to throw. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Marcus Davenport just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. First and second down were a disaster. Both went backwards. Now it's 3rd and 18. They need something big. A play fake. Now Cunningham. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And the Saints will have the football as this is taken up past the 30. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Here we go on 2nd and 12. And he can't escape, and down he goes. Michael Strahan. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. They'll set up to throw. And that is incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover. But doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction. He's going to sling this deep downfield. He's got a man complete.
Oh, my God. I ain't hit my foul. You fucking moron.
And that's going to add 15 more onto the end of this thing. A lack of discipline defensively on 4th down, and now that leads to a 1st and 10. They'll look to throw here. Oh, he stays up. But he can't get away forever, and down he goes. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. 2nd and 24. He'll drop to throw. Looking downfield for Jones. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. picked off inside the five. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They set themselves behind the chains, trying to get it all back in one play, and it backfired.
Didn't it feel like a pitcher working his way into a 3-0 count, right? You're behind. What do your coaches always tell you? Get it back one pitch at a time. In this case, they tried to get it back right away, and it didn't work out.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
Tough defensive game, man. Nobody really can do shit.
Running again with Barkley on second down. And
wow.
Once more, this play going in the wrong direction.
I ran the ball 13 fucking times.
It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings
13
up the third
times.
Down.
13 times, yeah.
From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. That'll give them 8 that time, and that's going to bring up a 4th down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a 1st down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And they'll run for it with Barkley. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10.
Dormant. Man, it's been a defensive game, bro.
Now Saquon Barkley. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. That's going to wind up a loss of a...
Come on, bro, don't quit. No! Damn, yo. Let me do the solo challenge show. Let's see what's up with this show.
Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach with you here today for another edition of Madden Ultimate Team. To finish this out, here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
This challenge begins in the first quarter with 2 minutes left on the clock. We're still without a score, tied at 0. Your opponent has the ball at midfield, and it's 1st and 10. And they'll begin by running the option. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. Here's Jackson. Room to run inside the 40 and down to the 29-yard line.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender. And that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
Play action. Now Jackson. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Carl Banks gets him for a loss of 10 yards from his linebacker spot. So now 20 yards to go on 2nd down after the sack. Work to be done. Jackson now. That one complete to Prochet. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Andrews. And Andrews lost the football. And this is picked up by the Bears. Congratulations on yet another victory. Now you can go right to the next challenge if there's another one available.
Well, that's it for right now, y'all. I'm about to hit y'all up like later on. Plus, my remote control is dying too. You know what I mean? It's getting late, so I hit y'all up later on. Start streaming later on. You'll follow me on Instagram. You can follow me on Facebook. You'll follow me on YouTube as well as Twitch. Twitch, the name is SmokeyBlack19750. On YouTube, name is Kareem Thomas. Platform, color is green. It's a lot of Kareems in the rooms. Found that out like last year. So, holla at your boy. I'll holla at y'all later on. Y'all be safe, yo. Have a good weekend. One.